really fun to watch those kids embrace that situation, to see the excitement, and not really nervousness, but excitement. You know, no one threw up this time. Nobody was gun shy. They just wanted to play. And when you looked at our dugout, you could see the excitement. You could see them just enjoying the moment. And as a coach, all you really want is them to embrace the moment they're in and just play for it and not play with fear. And I thought we did a really good job. Even though we struck out a lot, no one looked scared, no one looked nervous, they just played. And they felt like any second one of us was gonna change that game. And even the Emory game was the same way, the Williams game was the same way, and Texas Lutheran game was the same way. You know, a couple bounces here, a couple bounces there. All those games could change, but their demeanor never changed, and they stayed confident, and they just had fun. You know, last year we probably had the most lineups ever had. You know, we yanked Laney early in the year, we yanked seniors. We had, you know, probably 10 different lineups throughout the year. We're changing people late in the season, and they didn't care. They trusted every one of them. If they had tried on the jersey, everyone in the dugout felt when they came in, we were fine. And they didn't care when they came in, who they came in for, as long as they came in and just played hard and respected the team. And every day they just did that. And it was just fun to sit back and watch everybody just kind of get it.
When they say, trust the process through the coaches, trust the process. They know what they're doing, even if you in your mind at the moment say, well, why are we doing this? Just know that they know what they're doing and they'll get you there.
That season was the first time that we stepped outside of the bubble. And once we hit postseason, we did very little as coaches. I think that's the ideal dream of a coach is when you have players that just far exceed your expectation, and not as players, but as people. And they surrounded themselves and created their own world, and we just stood outside of it and watched them do magic.
They were relaxed, they knew what they were gonna do, they could have fun, and they just took care of business. And they executed so well in key spots of the games.
We definitely bonded a lot in Texas. We were very close the entire season. A lot of us hung out outside of softball, which I think really helped our team chemistry. And our coaches were along for the ride, always telling us, you're doing great, this is what you need to fix. Always constructive in a good way. And making it to the World Series with a team like that, it was something I'll never forget. And having coaches that told us how amazing we were, but also brought us down to the level of understanding that we got to keep our calm one inning at a time, each game at a time, before we get ahead of ourselves.
You know, obviously we're known as a team that hits well, but I thought our defense was probably the best we've had, and since I've been here, just working together and just playing. They just went out and made plays. It didn't matter if it's a simple backup. You know, you look at some of the plays they made where Kenna makes a diving play and flips it over to Claire. They were always on our rope together. And just played together really well. You know, could have been more proud of some of the young kids really stepping up. I mean, you look at Ashley had a couple of really big swings. And Kayla, you saw really, with Kenna struggling on offense, you kind of saw Kayla go in defense mode at the plate and say, okay, I'm going to step up for my sister here and get us some RBIs. And really, you've seen that carry over into this year into practice. And then in the fall season, her swing looked really good, and that aggressiveness has stayed, and you kind of see some of them starting to fight a little more.
So this season, our team goal is to win the whole thing, just like any other year. I don't think that goal will ever change. Personally, I got one more year, so I want to make sure I set the underclassmen up to be successful in the future. So working with our freshmen coming in, the infielders, the ones that are going to be taking over as the upperclassmen get out, I want to make sure that they're in the best situation they can be to fill the role and get themselves to a World Series once we leave. Being both an engineer and on the softball team, it definitely fills up your time. You're busy every second of every day. So you get really good at organization. You make lists upon lists. It really sets you up to be successful no matter where you go, because you're always going to be ready to get whatever you need done. Organization gets you a lot of places. My freshman year, I learned about a cool job where you get to go out, and for 3 years, you get a different job every year. They pay for your master's degree at the same time. You're going to leadership conferences. They set you up to be successful in both their company and wherever you end up. Throughout my years, I've had my eyes set on that, and luckily, after an internship there, I was able to get a spot within that company. I'll be out at BAE Systems in New York, in Binghamton. And for the next 3 years, I get to experience something new every year. I get to find something great, get a master's program in something I really like, and at the same time, keep developing my leadership skills.
I am a criminal justice and psychology double major, qualifying for nationals for a handgun team. It was my first ever competition in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and being able to say that I qualified to go to like the national event that's going to be in Kansas City was definitely, it was an experience for sure, and I know that it'll help me when I go into the criminal justice field. as a law enforcement officer. Personally, I really just want to, you know, send off our seniors on a really high note, a lot like we did last year, and, you know, be able to watch and see our freshmen grow and, you know, even our seniors continue to grow as they push forward to graduation, and, you know, everybody else on the team, you know, just kind of be there for them.
You know, I think you look at our roster, obviously, with Kenna being out, she'll be back at some point, we believe. You know, obviously, I feel Kenna's one of the best players in the country defensively. And, you know, Mercedes Doherty last year was a DH. This year, I think she'll get to play a lot more defense. She has really matured and gotten more athletic. Swing looks good, but her glove works a lot better. And so I think she'll get to fight for some innings. You know, Haley Springer's name last year, as I've talked about, that I feel like is ready. And this year, I really see a different change in her in the fall. She crushed it offensively. We had a scrimmage, she hit really well. I think she'll take Laney's spot at third base as of right now. And I think you're starting to see her come into her own. And she's a kid that can swing with anyone when she's confident. Outfield-wise, I mean, you have to talk about, you know, Kayla is probably one of the best center fields, I think, in the country with her arm and her range and her turns and her leadership. She took two freshmen last year and made them play really well. And I don't know who's going to be left and right. There's two freshmen pushing for spots, two sophomores trying to keep those spots. And the nice thing is you see all four of those kids interacting, getting along. There's no selfishness in that. They're going to push each other. Whoever we pick, they're going to support.
Going into the season, I'm kind of just putting it in my head that, yes, we had a big year last year, but we also need to focus on the goal and not let that be something we rely on. We need to, like, understand that that's not that exact team anymore. We're a whole new team, and we need to focus and retake every little bit of what we have as a team now and push towards that goal.
Yeah, obviously, if Porter come back behind the dish, a senior that has great command of her pitching staff, brings that comfort, kind of settles it down and just, you know, obviously just does her thing. And obviously, Campman on the mounds is exciting to have her back after a great junior year. And I challenged her over the summer and said, hey, if you look at all our pitchers in the past, very few have had better senior years than junior years. It's like junior year is always that peak year. I'm challenging you to have your best year as a senior. And I think she's on pace to do that.
Last season was pretty successful as a team. It was really fun, and I know I evolved a lot and became like a bigger person and learned a lot of things on the mound and with my teammates. And I think as a class, I know we haven't won conference tournament yet, so I think that's something we really want to accomplish.
For me, this year the goal is to make the pitching staff the best that I can be and be competitive with all the other pitching staffs. We lost Kate last year, and now we have Hannah, and then we have to bring up the new freshmen to make them as good as Kate was or better to make it to the national championship.
One thing we're looking forward to this season is, you know, last year we were not very quick, people that saw us play. I think we have some things defensively that we had some weaknesses last year that we have fixed this year. People that try to attack a certain way last year, this year, if they try that, I think we'll be a lot better defensively, which will help. We have a lot more team speed, more lefties in the lineup possible, with some faster righties as well. We still have the threat to go long with the long ball, but I think we can attack you different ways now. You know, everyone knew last year at the fence, we make a double, we made a stop at one. This year now, we should be able to push the envelope a little bit with some more speed, and we have more pitch running off the bench, we have more depth off the bench, so we should be able to look at righty-lefty matchups and figure out our best lineup. We have five pitchers on staff we feel comfortable throwing, so we can attack you a little differently this way as well. So I think we have more depth than we had in the past. We have really good talent, and as long as the girls don't let it become an issue, it should be one of our biggest strengths is how we can approach each game and each pitcher with the best lineup to attack that defense.
I don't think a coach genuinely goes in each year. Yeah, the wins matter, the losses matter, the rankings, all that stuff's important. But I think when you step into what you're doing and trying to accomplish each year, it's still the same. Genuinely being there with these players, with these young women, and showing them who they are. Because if we can teach them confidence and just grace and passion and develop them into the people that they were meant to be, the people that we saw when we started recruiting them, if we can successfully do that throughout the course of the four or five months that we get to play, then that's success. And so every year that never changes. And that's what the core of our culture is. They come in and become the players that they are because of the belief system that's wrapped around them. I mean, it's where our heart is.